Peter Schwarzenbauer, President and CEO of Porsche Cars North America.
You also have a hybrid coming out. Tell us about those.
Yes, first of all, I agree 100% with you. Yes, we have a very, very exciting product here. And we are currently developing the hybrid concept for the Cayenne. And we recently announced that we also will have a hybrid concept for the four-door, which will be launched in 2009. And we are also going to include a hybrid engine in this car. So the issue with our hybrid is, we could have just bought one and put it in, but that's not the Porsche way of doing things. We wanted to find something where we retain the performance characteristics of a typical Porsche, but add basically the advantages of a hybrid. And this is why it's taking us maybe a little bit longer than we originally expected.
How long do you think before you will actually have a Porsche hybrid on the US market?
We can do a first test drive, I would say, by 2010.
It's a little bit tough for you, Lamborghini, Rolls-Royce, Ferrari, Maserati. You're caught in a world of mass market, and you guys are not mass marketers. You have niche cars that people drive, not nearly as much as people who commute, and yet you're having to meet the same regulations as commuter cars are. That's going to be difficult for you.
Oh, it's very difficult, and honestly, we also think it's pretty unfair. We don't deny that we have responsibilities to improve also our fuel economy. There's no doubt about it, and we are doing this. But on the other hand, I mean, it's just not fair to be thrown in, as you mentioned it, in this mass volume manufacturer category, because, I mean, we don't have a small car where we can average out certain fleet consumptions. We only have very powerful, very exciting cars in our lineup.
Have you combat that not only in the US but in Europe?
I mean, in general, we are trying to explain basically to everybody who wants to hear it and the people who don't want to hear it that we have to be treated fair. And fair means what is technology possible in a reduction of a car like our characteristics. Because, let's face it, nobody needs a Porsche. People are buying our cars because they love it, they are excited about driving around in our cars. And if we want to continue to offer such a product, we have to have a fair chance of being able to compete in this marketplace. And this is what we are currently not seeing.
How are you ever going to make 35 miles per gallon? Do you do it by reducing the weight of your car? How do you do it?
I mean, I can't give you now the final answer because our engineers are still working on this issue. This 35 target is pretty new now. And we, of course, have huge challenges in order to go into this direction. There must be a combination of lightweight, different engine types. We still see a lot of potential in reducing fuel consumption, petrol engines. So there are a lot of things we can do, and we are going to do. But still, 35 miles per gallon is probably not a fair way of measuring our improvements compared to other people.
Because you take weight out of your car, but then you have to put safety in, which increases your weight. You've already got gas turbo direct injection in your car, which increases performance and increases fuel mileage. Unless you change your car drastically, you're not going to be able to meet that mile per gallon.
Absolutely. I mean, and we are taking this extremely serious. I mean, you can see here now the new Cayenne standing around here. We improved the power output, so more fun, which is what we are selling. But at the same time, we reduced fuel consumption by 15%. So we are working into this direction since years already on our petrol engines. But again, to come to 35 miles per gallon will be something extremely, extremely challenging.
It's going to be really hard for the lottery winners, because every time you see a lottery winner and they go, what are you going to do? They say, I'm going to buy a Porsche. So they're going to have to be a lottery winner almost to buy your cars.
It's definitely will add a lot of costs to our cars, there's no doubt about it. Yeah.
Well, hopefully the people that are making these decisions are taking your cars into account, because they are beautiful.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Peter.